is called Diamond. Create that environment for your potatoes. We have created the environment. You have to handle them with care. This room is warm. Let me switch off the light and close the door.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is She Africa, ndiri mukunda we Africa. That means I am the daughter of Africa. So thank you guys for watching my videos, and I want to thank you guys for supporting me. I really appreciate. If you are new here on She Africa, please don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment. And guys, today I just want to share with you what I am doing. I'm planning to do potato farming, and this is my first time doing that, doing potato farming, and I'm learning, but I have something that I can share with you from the day that I bought my potato tubes so that I can put them on the ground. So let me show you what I did, my journey so far. So I'm sure it's been 2 weeks from the day that we bought these potato tubes. As you can see, there are some potato tubes in front of me, and there are 200 potato tubes. So I went to Kutsaga. Kutsaga is a company which provide farming inputs to the farmers. So we went there, we asked our neighbor about it, and our neighbor told us you can go to Kutsaga or some companies that he gave us to choose from. The variety that we bought is called Diamond. As you can see, it is written Diamond G4. This kisti, it's there because there were kisti tubes in one of the pockets that were there. And guys, as you can see, what I want to share with you today is I was told by the agronomist that I saw that day when I purchased these potato tubes. So if you went to Kutsaga, they give you names of agronomists, and you can choose from, even they can give you two names or three names, you can choose from there which one would you like to call, so that you can be informed about how you can do your potato farming or your tobacco farming. So this is my first time doing potato farming, and I was told by the agronomist, you have to go and make sure that you wait for some days so that the potato will give shoots. So he told me the process. So the process, he told me, I came here and I used that method that he told me. So the method is, you have to, if you get your potato tubes, you have to make sure that you create a room for those tubes so that they will be able, they can have shoots. As you can see, these potatoes, potato tubes have shoots. These are the shoots. These are the shoots, guys. So this agronomist showed me that you have to create a room. In that room, make sure it's a dark room. You can create that environment for your potatoes. You yourself, you can, you are able to create that environment for your potato tubes so that they can shoot. But the thing is, right now we are in winter in my country, and during winter the process of potato tubes for them to shoot, to have shoots, it can be slow. It is slow during winter, and even the growth of the plants, and yeah, the growth is slow. So it can take days. If it means the normal days for potato tubes to shoot, it can take 2 weeks, or it can take 1 week. During winter, that means you can maybe add another week. So it will take 2 weeks for them to shoot. So right now we have 2 weeks now, and this is the result that we have. So we have created the environment. We made sure that the room is dark. We have switched off the light, and we cover the window so that the room will be very dark. And we have covered the potato tubes with a blanket. That's what we did, because
that first, in I'm sure, 3 days, we didn't manage to make that environment. We didn't know how to do it, and we thought, what are we going to do? There is nothing. There was nothing which was happening with the tubes. So we managed to create that environment. The other thing is, if you buy the tubes that have the shoots like this, you have to make sure that you handle them with care, because transportation is an issue if we talk about potato tubes with shoots. It is very, very difficult to transport potato tubes with shoots already, because the shoots are very soft and they are so fragile, they can break at any time. As you can see, guys, let me show you. As I'm talking to you about how the shoots, how fragile are the shoots of potato tubes. As you can see, I was trying to move this card box and some of the shoots, they are broken like this. These are the shoots. So you have to handle them with care. If there are some shoots, you have to handle your potato tubes with care, because they can break at any time because they are so fragile. Another thing that I want to share with you guys, the agronomist told me when I was purchasing, there were some big tubes like this, like these ones. In my mind, when I saw the agronomist, because the agronomist didn't have enough tubes of diamond, the diamond that we needed that time, and he was saying, is it possible for us to give you these small ones, these small tubes? In my mind, I said to myself, no, I don't want the small tubes. Why would I take small tubes? I don't want that. And he told me, small tubes are good and they are better. They can even have more shoots than the big ones. And I said, no, I don't want that. Please, maybe if you can mix them, that will be better for me. Maybe I will see if I get home and I will compare them. So I have managed to compare them. It was true, and it is true, that small tubes of potatoes can have more shoots than the big tubes. Big tubes do not have many shoots, but if I'm comparing them right now, I see as if it's true. Small tubes have many shoots. So you can comment, guys, just comment below and give me tips on how to do potato farming, because this is my first time. And just comment below about what I'm saying and what I've learned so far from what I'm trying to do about potato farming. Let me show you the room, the environment that we have created. And guys, so this is the blanket that we are using. It's dirty, as you can see. So this is the blanket that we are using. And let me close my potato tubes. This is how I do it. We are in that room, the dark room, but the only thing is right now the light is on, and we must switch off that light. This is it. The potato tubes need a very warm and good temperature for them so that they can have shoots. So this room is warm, and it's also dark. Let me switch off the light and close the door so that you can see how dark is this room. Okay, this is the room, guys. It's so dark. Switch on the light. This is it, guys. We've managed to create this environment on our journey of learning. We are learning how to do potato farming. So we are starting with only 200 tubes of potatoes on an open field. You can't control the temperatures. You can't create your own temperature or whatever it is. But during winter, the growth of crops, it will be very slow, and the temperatures during winter can slow down the growth of the crops. And also even here we can experience it when right now as we are trying to do our potato farming. So we've created the environment for our potato tubes, and they are ready now for us to take them to the ground. We are going to put them on the ground, and we are going to show you the process. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment below. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.